Hurricane Matthew is slamming Haiti and heading to Cuba. The storm continues to move up right through the middle of the Caribbean with its path set on Cuba, Haiti, and the Bahamas over the next 24 to 48 hours. Matthew is bringing life-threatening winds and storm surges, some areas seeing up to 40 inches of rain. Plus, this morning, we're getting a look at Hurricane Matthew from space. This is an image from the International Space Station showing just how wide Hurricane Matthew has grown. We've been tracking this for you every day here on Daybreak since it was a tropical storm. Matt Kirkwood joins us now with the latest on the hurricane's path. Matt, you're saying some troubling news out there.
Yeah, Terry and I were just talking. She mentioned that the hurricane just intensified another 80 miles an hour, and it's already a major hurricane out there. And what's become a little more interesting is the potential track of Hurricane Matthew. And I'll get to that in just a moment. But here's a representation of it with the satellite and also the radar. Not many radars down here in this portion of the world. But you could see, if you look closely, a little bit of an eye there. This is Tiburon Peninsula in Haiti. It's going to make landfall. Hurricane Matthew is going to make landfall in the next couple of hours or so in Les Cayes. One of the towns in the Tiburon Peninsula just received a wind gust of 137 miles per hour. As we continue through the rest of the day, it's going to head up towards extreme eastern part of Cuba, just west or just east of Guantanamo Bay. But look at this. Once it gets beyond Cuba, it starts taking more of a northwestern track, and it looks like now Hurricane Matthew, as a major hurricane, possibly as a Category 4, will go right through the center of the Bahamas, which includes the most populated island of Nassau, and that certainly isn't good news. And it also brings it closer to the eastern coast of Florida, which puts Miami in play, and also Daytona, Jacksonville, Florida. And as it continues its trek northward, we're looking at sometime on Saturday, Friday, Saturday time frame, coming very close to the Carolinas, could come into South Carolina, for instance, Savannah. But right now, the official hurricane track has it coming into Wilmington, North Carolina, sometime late Saturday evening. And so this has obviously shifted westward, and certainly would include hurricane force winds, or at least tropical force winds, all along the coast from the mid-Atlantic states right down to Miami. Quite incredible.